When it comes to smartphones in 2023, I've used a great deal of them. The Galaxy S23 Ultra, the Pixel Fold, the Z Fold 5, the Google Pixel 8 Pro, the OnePlus Open. But there's only one phone that gets my recommendation for 2023 Phone of the Year, and it is the iPhone 15 Pro Max. I know. Y'all got questions. So let's talk about it. What's up, people? This your boy, Viper, the man about tech, back again for the video. And yes, it was long. It was hard. I've used all the phones. But at the end of the day, this phone right here, the iPhone 15 Pro Max, is my 2023 smartphone of the year, the best phone that you could buy right now with your hard-earned money. But, of course, you're wondering, Viper, what led you to that conclusion? Well, the moment you take this phone out of the box, it just feels different. It's so thin. It's so light. I mean, look at how thin this phone is. Look at it. It's so thin. It's so light. And that is because of the titanium frame that Apple has included with the iPhone 15 Pro Max this year. Titanium weighs a little bit less than stainless steel, a little bit more durable as well, and it comes together to make a great package when it comes to the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Just using the phone is so much more comfortable since it's not as heavy. Not to say that I was having so much trouble lifting the 14 Pro Max, but you get my drift. The 15 Pro Max is just a joy to hold and use. It's just different. Now, obviously, if you're using an older iPhone, maybe like the iPhone 13 or the iPhone 12, the difference should also be apparent to you because those phones were stainless steel as well. But anybody who's coming directly from a 14 Pro to a 15 Pro or Pro Max, you're going to feel the weight difference almost immediately. But if we turn this phone to the side, what you will notice immediately is the action button. That's right, that extra button right there at the top, right above the volume up button. It is a brand new feature on this year's iPhones, and it is something that I use every day. It's kind of been the butt of jokes on social media, but as the captain of Team Apple, let me tell you, I use it every day. Viper, how do you use your action button? I'll tell you. Camera launching, of course. I don't know how many of you all use Android, but if you double tap the power button on most Androids, it opens directly into the camera app. iPhone has never had anything like that. Yeah, we had the camera app as a shortcut on the lock screen, but that's not as quick and efficient as having a dedicated button here to open up the camera app. So that's what I have the action button mapped to. You can have it mapped to other things like your flashlight. You can have it mapped to shortcuts. I think there's like 9 different functions that you can have your action button mapped to. Now, the one thing that I wish Apple would have did a little differently with the action button is that right now you have to tap and hold to activate whatever function that you have mapped to it. I wish you could double tap it or triple tap it to allow multi-function operability of the action button. Meaning, maybe I can tap and hold to open the camera button like normal, but maybe I double tap it and that would take a screenshot or something like that, or triple tap it to launch a timer or something. Just different levels of presence that will allow us to add functionality to the action button. So Apple, this is something that you should definitely look at in a future update or a future iPhone if it's not capable. But that's just how I feel about it. The other thing that you notice as you're using this iPhone is zipping around iOS 17. iOS 17 has been a joy to use, especially as opposed to iOS 16, which had its bugs. I've come across very little, if no, bugs in iOS 17. It's fluid, it's fast, it's responsive, it works the way it's supposed to. It kind of gets back to what the iPhone and iOS have become known for. It just works. Steve, we see you, baby. But it just works. And I love using it. And when talking about iOS 17, I need to mention the dynamic island. I made fun of it when it launched last year, but it's definitely come in handy for me, especially when I'm traveling to see how long it takes for my Uber to arrive or if I'm going with Uber Eats. It shows how far out the driver is, or if you just set a timer, you can see how much time you have left on the timer that you set via the dynamic island. So it's definitely become a useful feature on iOS. I dig it. The other thing about the iPhone 15 Pro Max is the fact that the speakers on here, I would say, are a tad bit better than the 14 Pro Max. And if you have an older iPhone, they might be a little bit better than those. Will you notice a marked difference? I don't know, but Me coming from the 14 Pro Max, using the 15 Pro Max, I think the speakers are a little bit better. But one thing that is definitely better on the 15 Pro Max is the camera system. Now, when you take a picture with the iPhone 14 Pro or Pro Max, you are essentially getting a 12 megapixel picture, which means you got 12 million pixels that come together to create an image. Remember, the more pixels that you are able to have access to, the sharper your image will be, which means the image will have more clarity. This phone gives you double the pixels because the camera naturally takes the pictures and outputs them at 24 megapixels, which means there's a lot more detail in the pictures that you take with this iPhone 15 Pro Max. You can look at the B-roll, let me know what you think about the pictures that I want to put up here and show you right now. But pictures on this phone are going to be better than the pictures on your iPhone 14 or 13 or 12, because again, Apple upped the default megapixel resolution to make the images more sharper and clearer. So that is a definite advantage of this phone. Not to mention that the 15 Pro Max is still the best in class for video. There is no phone on planet Earth that takes better video than the iPhone in its entirety, but especially the iPhone 15 Pro Max. You want a video camera in your pocket? You want to be like Quentin Tarantino or Michael Bay or whoever the best director in Hollywood is right now, Ryan Coogler or John Favreau of Marvel fame? If you want that power in your hand, you pick up this iPhone 15 Pro Max, and I promise you, you'll be shooting pictures like Spielberg in no time.
There we go.
So you got your boy Viper here with my man Nick Roney of Just Another Year Chicago. We are live at Murphy Bleachers out here for the Chicago Bears game. Nick is a sports content creator, and Nick, I just want to know, how did you go about setting this up, getting an establishment to let you host an event for them, or with them?
So Murphy's Bleachers, historic bar in Wrigleyville, Illinois, been open since the 70s, you know, family owned, and it's a Chicago icon. That's what we're here for. We're here to talk about Chicago sports. We're here to be about the Bears, about the Cubs, anybody. Murphy's is the place to come. You come early, you come often, people love it here, and it fits everything about being an optimistic Chicago sports fan. So why not at Murphy's Bleachers?
Okay, maybe I exaggerated a little bit, but the camera quality, the video quality is A1. There's no smartphone to take a better video today than the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Now, one of the immediate bugaboos of the phone when it was initially released was HeatGate 2023, meaning the phone ran a little bit warm depending on what you were doing. Even when you were doing basic tasks like web browsing, media consumption, stuff like that, the phone would get warm. But that has since been fixed in a software update that Apple released a few weeks ago. I have had no issue with heat with the phone since the update was released. I was experiencing those heat issues. Not nothing crazy, but I did experience the phone get warm before the update was released. But since the update's been released, the heat has been managed, so you're good to go. So if you heard about heat issues with the phone, it's been fixed. We good to go. You know, there's just something special about iPhones and just knowing how to pick up an iPhone and use it. The It Just Works model. Being able to click an app icon, go into an app, not to mention Face ID still fast as ever on his iPhone. You being able to give an iPhone to your parents or grandparents and having them use it easily. iMessage still being the thing. And starting next year, iMessage will be even better, or messaging people with iPhone will be even better, because iPhones are going to adopt RCS. If you don't know what that is, I made a video about it. Check the top here or check the end screen. But messaging your Android friends is going to get a lot better next year with a software update from Apple, because they're going to support RCS. So just using an iPhone just to communicate, use your favorite apps. We know that apps on here usually look and run the best, especially as it relates to social media apps like an Instagram, Snapchat. They just work best on iPhone. So when you're using an iPhone to do things like that and communicate with your friends, you are using the best phone available out there. Again, not to say that the Android phones are bad, but when it comes to just using a phone that just works, and especially a phone that pretty much everybody here in the US has, it's iPhone, and it's nobody even close. The other major change to iPhone that we have to talk about is the port. Yes, USB Type-C has officially come to iPhone, and it's glorious. Now, some of y'all might see this as an inconvenience because you were using Lightning for the past 10 years. But let me tell you, as a guy that's on the cutting edge of technology, You want this USB Type-C port in this iPhone because that is the port that most devices support today. Even Apple has other devices that support USB Type-C, like their MacBooks, like their iPads, like their new AirPods Pro. So Apple is starting to slowly converge all their devices to support USB Type-C. So it's only right that we finally have the support on iPhone. This I'm definitely a fan of. Not to mention, if you need to transfer files from your iPhone to your MacBook, this USB Type-C port makes that process a lot faster because this port is up to 20 times faster than the transfer that you were getting with the Lightning port. So you should definitely be crying and rejoicing in tears of rejoice if you are using your iPhone to transfer files to your MacBook. That is a game changer. I forgot to talk about the battery life on this iPhone 15 Pro Max. It's decent. You'll get about the same as you were getting with the iPhone 14. If you have an iPhone 13 Pro, you're probably gonna experience a little dip. If you're coming from anything other than an iPhone 13 Pro, you are going to have great battery life. It's gonna be about a day, maybe beyond, given how you use your device. But if you have a 13 Pro, the battery on the 15 Pro Max is not as good as the 13 Pro Max, so just be aware of that.
So with the camera quality, the weight being trimmed, the efficiency of iOS 17, all these things and more come together to make this the best phone that you can buy right now. And again, if you want to see why your iPhone messaging with your Android friends is going to get so much better next year, check out that video right there to find out all about it.